welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I want to show you guys what I'm actually wearing on a daily basis. So this is my real life actual sneaker rotation. You guys know that I do buy a lot of sneakers and I do tend to buy a lot of the more so like hype stuff, like all the Dunks and things like that. But the truth is, I don't actually wear a lot of my sneakers, and what I'm wearing on a daily basis isn't actually that hype. Well, there's like a bit of a low-key hype. It's not as hyped as a lot of the other sneakers that I just have sitting in my apartment. I don't know why I do this. Let me know in the comments below whether you guys are the same. Like, do you have a lot of hype sneakers but you just end up wearing the same things over and over again? Because that is definitely me. So yeah, I thought I'll share that with you guys today. And I also picked up a few things from Farfetch, which I'm super excited as well. I picked up two pairs of sneakers, which I plan on adding to my daily sneaker rotation, and also like pants and socks. So yeah, I'll show you guys that later in the video. But let's start off with the first pair of sneakers, which is the Nike Zoom Vomero 5s. I've spoken about this sneaker briefly in my underrated sneaker video because I honestly feel like these are super underrated, and I love how they look like on feet. They do have a very retro kind of vibe, but I do love the color and just the overall design of the sneaker. But most importantly, they are really comfortable and pillowy on feet. If I'm not mistaken, this first came out in 2010 and they are designed to be a running sneaker. Obviously, if you're just wearing this as a lifestyle sneaker just to, you know, walk around, you can be assured that these feel really great on feet. And yeah, I love these a lot, and I've definitely worn these so much. I do want to pick them up in the tonal colorways as well. And a few of my friends actually managed to get these below retail. So if you ever come across a pair, I highly recommend them. In terms of sizing, I'm wearing this in a men's 6.5, and my true to size is a men's size 6. So I've gone half a size up and they feel really good on feet. So yeah, I would recommend going half a size up if you want to, but I think even if you go true to size, you should be fine. I cannot say enough good things about these sneakers. I feel like they're just like a good, like, you know, I'm not really trying to flex, it's just nice and low key, and I just really love how they look. And because I love the Vomero 5 so much, I finally picked up the A Cold Wall version. So these came out in 2018. And I can't believe it took me so long to finally pick up a pair. And I got these from Farfetch because they have a really great sneaker selection. And the one thing that I'm always impressed by with Farfetch is how fast their shipping is. So I actually ordered this on a Thursday or Friday night here in Australia, and I got it on a Tuesday. So to me, that is super quick. This did come from the States. So in terms of their like hype sneaker section, they come from Stadium Goods because Farfetch did acquire Stadium Goods in 2018. So you can be assured that the sneakers are definitely legit. If you guys have any issues with sizing and stuff, the return policy is really great, so you don't have to stress too much about that. But yeah, I'm so happy that I finally picked up the A Cold Wall version because, like I said, I love the Zoom Vomero 5s because they are, again, super comfy. And of course, because this is the A Cold Wall version, it does have the A Cold Wall branding, like here on the toe box area of the sneaker, as well as the insole. And the most obvious design element on this sneaker would be this protruding heel counter. I think they look quite good. I know it does look a little bit bulky, and initially when I unboxed the sneakers, I was just like, did I get the wrong size? Because it does look a little bit bigger because this does protrude. But no, I got this in the right size. I got this in a men's 6.5. They feel great on feet, and I really love the all black colorway. And yeah, I can't wait to add this to my everyday sneaker rotation because you can't go wrong with an all black sneaker. And I feel like this just adds something that's a little bit different in terms of like the aesthetic of the sneaker, and I feel like they look great. And to go with the A Cold Wall Vomeros, I also picked up these A Cold Wall socks because you guys know I love me a pair of A Cold Wall socks. In my last few videos, I kept talking about the cream colored A Cold Wall socks, but I think they're sold out now, but those are great. So I had to pick up another pair, and this time around I picked up a all black one because I wanted to pair it with my A Cold Wall Vomeros, and I really like how it has the branding on the back of the socks. And then on the front here, you guys can see there's just like a gray stripe that goes on the center front. And yeah, I think they look look super sleek with these sneakers. And you guys know that I have a promo code with Farfetch that gives you 10% off, and I'll leave it on the screen right now so you guys can use that when you check out. But at the end of the video, I'll share with you guys some recommendations that I recommend that you pick up from Farfetch, because yeah, generally a lot of my clothing I have picked up from Farfetch, and I think they have such a good selection, so I have to remember to mention that at the end of this video. But yeah, the socks are really great, and yeah, I'm super happy that I picked these up. So moving on to some other sneakers, I feel like Jordan 1s are super essential to anyone's sneaker collection. So I have two pairs here that I wear all the time, and I have a pair of mids and a high. So with my mids, I have the light smoke gray, which I picked up earlier this year, and I just really love how these look. I think the neutral colorway is really great. I know a lot of people are not really a fan of mids, but to me, I don't really mind how they look like on feet, and with my on feet footage, my pants are so baggy that you can't even tell that they're mids, but I think the colorway is great. And like I said, the Jordan 1s are a super timeless classic silhouette, and the other pair that I wear a lot is the Obsidian colorway. And yeah, these have definitely risen in price over time, and I'm not too sure why. They've gotten more and more hype. Like initially, I don't think people really cared for them. I think Jordan 1s in general are hyped in their own way, but I feel like these are super essential to anyone's sneaker collection. And yeah, it doesn't matter which colorway you go for, but personally for me, I like these two because this is super neutral, and with the Obsidians, I just really love these color blocking. And yeah, they both look really great on feet. And did you guys know that my Obsidians are like in a men's size 7? It's not even in my size, but you know, sometimes you have to take what you can get. And yeah, I don't think it's that obvious that they're too big for me, but in terms of Jordan 1s, I find that they are true to size, so just go for your regular sizing. So the next pair of sneaker is actually a new addition to my collection, which I also picked up from Farfetch, and this is the Nike Sakai Blazers, and this did come out last year. And I actually always wanted a pair of these as well, but just never ended up picking it up. I went for the neutral colorway because, again, with my daily sneaker rotation, I don't want anything that's too crazy. I want something that goes well with everything, that I don't have to think too much about. And I tried these on feet and I love how they look so much. I know that the waffle silhouette is definitely way more popular in terms of the Sakai collaboration, but I think the blazers are really great. And yeah, I honestly really, really love these. And because it is a Sakai collab, it does have all the, I guess, signature Sakai design principles with the layering of the elements on the sneaker. So you guys can see it has the double laces, double Nike swishes, double tongue, you guys get the idea. And yeah, these to me are a very like low-key flex. Would you call this a low-key flex? I feel like I'm gonna call that a low-key flex because the waffles are definitely a little bit more popular, but to me the blazers are really great. And I paired it with these a cold wall track pants that I picked up from Farfetch as well. This is under the men's line, and I got this in a size small and it fits me really good. And I just love the colorway of this because it is a nice like beige color, and I think it works really well for the Sakai blazers because it is a white pair of sneakers. And of course it does have the subtle a cold wall branding, like here on the front you can see it has the a cold wall branding on the knee, and you can also see some details on the back of the pants over here. For some reason, I don't really own any pants in this color, so I decided to pick this up because I think it would pair well with a lot of my lighter colored sneakers. So I'm really glad I picked this up, and yeah, I think this looked great. I really love a cold wall track pants, and I have another one that I wear all the time, but because it's so old, I can never find a link for you guys. But if you are interested in some a cold wall track pants, they do have quite a few up on the Farfetch website right now, so I highly recommend that you guys check it out. But anyway, back to the blazers. I am absolutely in love with these, and I can't believe it took me so long to pick up a pair. I really love the neutral colorway, but they do have them in a few other colorways, which I think looks really great. So I might think about picking them up in the future, but for now, I'm super happy with these. Next up, we have some Ultra Boost, and I feel like Ultra Boost are just essential in anyone's sneaker collection. If you don't have an Ultra Boost, you need to go out and like buy a pair immediately. These are good for everyday wear because they are super comfortable. I'm sure sure you guys already know this by now. And I have two pairs that I wear all the time. And this one here is actually one of my favorite sneakers that I have in my whole collection. And I would say that this is definitely a very low-key flex. So this is a pair of Adidas Ultra Boost 1.0 J&D Collective. And this came out in 2015. I'm actually surprised at how well I've kept this. And this was actually a gift from a friend. And I just love these a lot. And because it was a J&D Collective, it was pretty hard to get at that time. And yeah, you know, there are really subtle details on the sneaker, but you don't necessarily have to get this particular Ultra Boost. I think any Ultra Boost is good because, like I said, they're really comfortable. I think the Ultra Boost is super versatile because you can wear it to like the gym or just as an everyday lifestyle sneaker. So with the white pair, I wear it more so as a lifestyle sneaker, and the one that I wear to go running to the gym when the gyms were open is the all black pair. And this one came out earlier this year. It's part of the Chinese New Year collection. And yeah, because it's all black, again, I feel like I don't have to fuss about it getting dirty. With my Ultra Boost, I always go at least half a size up or even one full size up. So with my 1.0s, I have this in a 6.5. And then with this version that came out this year, I have it in a men's size 7, and they both fit really good. So next up, I have a pair of sneakers that I've never spoken about on my channel before because it's definitely not a hype pair of sneakers, but I feel like it is another very timeless silhouette and something that I wear all the time when I don't want to think too much about it. And it is the Maison Margiela replica sneakers. To me, these are, you know, I feel like they look really clean, really good. Mine obviously are quite worn, and I haven't been that careful with these, and I don't actually mind how they look even if they're a little bit dirty. They do have this in a bunch of different colorways, but I do love this classic like white gray with the gum sole. I wear these pretty often, and on my on feet you can see I'm wearing it with some light cream colored pants, which is my Uniqlo Carpenter pants that I've spoken way too much about, so I'm not gonna bring it up again. They are fairly comfortable. Obviously you can't compare it to the comfort of the Ultra Boost or the Vomero. The leather on the sneaker is nice and soft, and I would say that these fit true to size, so just go for your regular sizing. I got this in a size 39, and I'm usually like a 38, but I need to stop buying sneakers that are not my size, guys. But yeah, these are true to size, so just go for your regular sizing. So next up is the Undercover Daybreaks, which I have spoken about quite a few times on my channel as well. And to me, this is another super underrated sneakers. And you guys can tell, I obviously love these a lot because I have them in four different colorways. And yeah, these did come out in like men's and women's colorways, but they are definitely a very unisex sneaker. This one here was part of the men's collection, but they did run it in a men's size 6. I believe that was the smallest size, but you guys can see with the women's version, it doesn't have as much contrast, but essentially it is the same silhouette, just in different colorways. And yeah, these ones I definitely wear all the time, but out of the four that I have, I would say that this one is my most worn one, and you can definitely see a lot of signs of wear on this particular sneaker. I just really love how they look like on feet. It does have the heel counter, which I think makes it look a little bit different, and it does have the subtle undercover branding. In terms of sizing, I find that they fit true to size, so I have all of them in a men's 6 or a women's 7.5. Obviously at this stage you have to find them on a secondary market, but you can definitely get them for a really reasonable price, and I highly recommend them. If you're after like an everyday sneaker that's just a little bit different, I would definitely go for these. And yeah, I can't say enough good things about the Undercover Daybreak. Out of all my sneakers, in terms of most underrated sneaker, they would be the Undercover Daybreaks as well as the Vomeros. Last but not least, you guys know that I have to have a pair of Yeezys in my everyday sneaker rotation, and it is the Yeezy 700 V3 in the Alva colorway. So even though I have the Azale and the Azeroth colorway, I would say that the Alva is definitely my most worn one out of the three. Because it is an all black sneaker, you can't really go wrong there, and it goes well with everything. And I just really love how the 700 V3s look like on feet, and I'm not going to go into too much detail on the sneaker because I have done a few videos on them already. So those are pretty much the sneakers that I have in my everyday sneaker rotation. And I want to quickly touch on the socks that I wore in this video because you guys tend to ask me about like my sock game. The socks that I was wearing with my Ultra Boost is this Noah Adidas socks that I picked up a few weeks ago because they did do a collaboration, and I got these on the Adidas website, and it came in a pack of three, and I just feel like these are really cute with the three stripes as well as the Noah embroidery. So another pair of socks that I think are super essential to your sock rotation. Is that even a thing? But yeah, another super essential pair of socks would be just your classic Nike socks. It usually comes in black or white, but these ones here are a little bit blue because I dip dyed these myself. If you guys are interested, I have posted a video about how you can dip dye socks, so yeah, check that out if you're interested. And then one more thing I want to tell you guys is that I was on the Farfetch site last night and I noticed that they restocked the Nike ACG cargo pants, which I have spoken about on my channel quite a few times now, and they restocked it. So if you were thinking about picking up a pair of these, I highly, highly recommend them. I just really love how they look, and you guys can use my 10% off promo code to get 10% off, so you can never complain with a bit of a discount. And I am wearing this in a size extra small, and I think it fits me really good. It is under the men's line, so yeah, you can, it's definitely unisex in my opinion. But yeah guys, that is pretty much it for me today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and you guys know that I shop on Farfetch all the time because I think they have such a great range of brands. Whether you're looking for your Nike, Adidas, or even luxury brands, they have it all. If you're after Off-White, Balenciaga, Gucci, Prada, it is all there. And a few other brands that I recommend that you guys check out on Farfetch is, well, these are my go-to brands, which is Ambush, Alix, A Cold Wall. Why do they all start with a letter A? A lot of my Prada pieces are from the Farfetch site as well. And the Prada bucket hat that you guys see all the time, I got it there. So I'll definitely link that down below. And I'm wearing that in a size medium in case you guys are wondering, because yeah, it does come in sizing. Highly recommend that bucket hat. But yeah guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I will see you guys really, really soon. Bye. And I would love to know your daily snaker. What? ages go. I bought a player. What? Super essential to anyone's sneaker. It is a unisex silhouette. Actually, everything that I'm mentioning is a unisex silhouette. So I don't even know why I brought that up. If you're after something that's not like super sporty and a little bit more, what is the word I'm looking for? Like, casual. You guys know what I mean, like casual smart kind of look, even though like, where am I going trying to dress all casual smart?